over here is the central business district of Sydney, and Newtown is just through here. The Inner West Cultural Services building is just over here. I'm here in Newtown in Sydney, Australia, and in front of this building here on Dixon Street. Now, for a start, as the crow flies, we are about 5 to 6 kilometres from the central CBD of Sydney, looking at the map there, and we can have a top-down look of this building right here. So within this building here, which is the Inner West Cultural Services building, and you can hire this building out, so for things like yoga and writing festivals and these sorts of things. And you can see into the building there, you can sort of see through. It's sort of quite a small building in a way. We have the plaque over here, and a closer look at that, we can see that it was, the building was, the stone was laid on the 13th of September in 1913. Within the design and inscription, we can see the Maltese cross at both the top and the bottom, and we can see the abbreviation AMDG. Now the G, that could be a C or a G, it's a little worn. Either way, both suit in this case. For the Latin phrase ad maiorem de gloriam, which in English translates to the greater glory of God. Now, this Latin motto is the motto of the Society of Jesus, the Jesuits. And indeed, you can see it on artworks, and you can see it on further inscriptions for foundation stones. So this is the outside of the building here, having a look at a few photos. So this is a home, and this was sort of through word of mouth. I hadn't sort of picked this up, but there is a group here at least, and it's sort of all a network in a way, but they're called the Templum Silenti. And the Templum Silenti would be part of the Gnostic Catholic Church of Australia. Okay, so we now find ourselves on the website of Templum Silenti, the Gnostic Catholic Church of Sydney. And let's just read from in here. So we have Templum Silenti exists to serve the brethren and their general public as a beacon for thelema throughout the region, expounding our creed through regular celebrations of thelemic religious rites, and in particular the Gnostic Mass, Liber 15, which is Book 15. Now, this particular Gnostic Mass was composed by Aleister Crowley, I believe. Let's look at thelema for a moment. So the word thelema would, in Greek, would relate to will or intention, which of course within the practice of magic is extremely important. Now, just looking through here at the history, one of the earliest mentions of this philosophy occurs in the classic Gargantua and Pantagruel, written by Francois Rabelais in 1532. Now, further down here, you can read thelema, do what thou will, and then later came Aleister Crowley into this. Just reading down here further, every man and every woman is a star. This is usually taken to mean that every individual is unique and has their own path in a spacious universe wherein they can move freely without collision. Yet further down here we can read, love is the law, love under will. This is an important corollary to the above.
indicating that the essential nature of the law of thelema is that of love. Each individual unites with his or her true self in love, and so empowered, the entire universe of conscious beings unites with every other being in love. Now, back to the website here. So just looking a little bit there at the thelema just for a moment. So thelema, referring again to will and intention, we now go to the Gnostic Mass here, and we'll just have a look at a bit of a video of this, and it's, you know, more of the play of the Gnostic Mass, and this is Crowley's writings, I believe.
Put on the wings and arouse the coiled splendor within you. Come unto me. Of women and spices, ye shall wear rich jewels. Ye shall exceed the nations of the earth in splendor and pride, but always in the love of me. And so shall ye come to my joy.
O secret of secrets that art hidden in the being of all that lives, not thee do we adore, for that which adoreth is also thou. Thou art that, and that am I. I am the flame that burns in every heart of man, and in the core of every star. I am life, and the giver of life. Yet therefore is the knowledge of me the knowledge of death. I am alone. There is no God where I am.
But ye, O my people, rise up and awake. Let the rituals be rightly performed with joy and beauty. There are rituals of the elements and feasts of the times. A feast for the first night of the prophet and his bride. A feast for the 3 days of the writing of the book of the law. A feast for Tahuti and the child of the prophet. Secret, O prophet. A feast for the supreme ritual and a feast for the equinox of the gods. A feast for fire, and a feast for water, a feast for life, and a greater feast for death. A feast every day in your hearts, in the joy of my rapture. A feast every night unto new, and the pleasure of uttermost delight.
Thou that art one, our Lord in the universe, the Son, our Lord in ourselves, whose name is mystery of mystery. Uttermost being, whose radiance enlightening the worlds is also the breath that maketh every god, even and death, to tremble before thee. By the sign of light appear thou glorious upon the throne of the sun. Make open the path of creation and intelligence between us and our minds. Enlighten our understanding. Encourage our hearts. Let thy light crystallize itself in our blood, fulfilling us of resurrection. Akadua tufurbio viashefu
dudunurafanuteru. There is no law beyond. Do what thou wilt.
Lao Tzu and Siddhartha and Krishna and Tahuti, Moshe, Dionysus, Mohammed, and
okay, so whilst those scenes may be a little tacky, it's still a bit of an idea of the Gnostic Mass, of Book 15 by Aleister Crowley. And that was just a snippet, and I'll leave it at that. We'll just keep moving through, just scrolling down. You can see the religious calendar here, and on the March equinox, which would of course be around the 19th to the 23rd, they have the feast for the equinox of the gods, and you heard that mentioned within the ritual there. But anyway, so held on the vernal equinox of each year to commemorate the founding of the Lemur in 1904.
And on March the 20th, the feast for the supreme ritual, the invocation of Horus. And further through here, down here, we have the ritual of the elements and feast of the times, observed at the equinoxes and solstices. And yet further we can read, 3 points of passage in the life of each Thelemite are observed. Birth is celebrated in a feast for life. Puberty is celebrated in a feast for fire for a boy, or a feast for water for a girl. And the death of the individual is commemorated in a greater feast for death. We now locate to the About Us page for Templum Salenti, and just reading through here for a moment, Templum Salenti is the Sydney branch of Ecclesia Gnostica Catholica, EGC, or Gnostic Catholic Church, the ecclesiastical branch of the Order of the Templi Orientis. The central rite of the EGC is the Gnostic Mass, which celebrates the law of Thelema, light, life, love, and liberty, through its sacrament, the mystic doctrines of the covenant of resurrection and the communion of saints. Now, further down here, see all of these sort of lodges and bits and pieces sort of tie in together in a way, if you look through it all, but so the Ecclesia Gnostic Catholica is led internationally by the Patriarch of the Church, Hymenius, Beta 12 there, with its Australian religious leader or primate, Shiva X. Shiva X is the leader in Australia. Now, Templum Salenti enjoys an ongoing fraternal collaboration with the Temple in Adelaide, the Temple of the Woman Clothed with the Sun, and Our Lady Babylon in Western Australia, delivering services and initiatives through the southwest region of Australia. Love is the law, love under will. So from the Templum Salenti site here, from the services page, we can see the Collective 777 here, which is an art guild of the Ordo Templi Orientis in Australia. That'll do for now. In part two, we will have a close look at Collective 777 and we will visit the town of New Norcia in Western Australia. Find the link for part two in the description box.